Okay, OAC, this is your, you're filming me back. I love it. This is the best. Okay, so here's the deal. You guys have student high district here at Brecksville. Coach Harvard, though, didn't know if it was like 12 or 15 years. How many years have you guys been here?
Here, it's at least 15.
So at least 15. Coach D-Tray walking by there, I like that.
Yeah.
Okay, but so you guys are always a growth mentality, okay?
Yes.
So you were out of the loop for a minute. Let's talk about you.
Yeah.
Where were you out of the loop at?
I was in Oshkosh, Wisconsin for about 7 years.
What was going on in Oshkosh, Wisconsin?
Work brought me there, but I stayed as close to wrestling as I could there. I coached a little bit there, but then eventually got to come back and coach at St. Mary's Junior High this year, and then been on the OAC circuit since our season's been over.
I saw you at the SBC.
Yeah.
The culmination of a brutal meat grinder of a year for the Panthers, right?
Yeah, it was an interesting year.
Well, I mean, dude, it's tough. Anything's tough. And that league's changed so much. As much as it stayed the same, it's changed because you've added, it's grown times three, right?
Yeah, it's completely different than before when I left. So that was all just starting. So
when you look at OAC and you look at, you know, growth of the SBC, growth of the OAC, what's it like? How do you guys keep up? How do you, you know, constantly push forward? You know, Jared's your cousin, Jude's your dad. What's it like with a growth mentality in a company?
Well, I think there's a really good partnership between Jared and my dad, and they really, you know, they know what they want. They want Ohio to be the best wrestling that possibly can. So they're coming up with ways to get, you know, people involved at whatever level they can compete at, you know. And then you've also got novice state that, you know, that goes out in Delta. So I think having as many options for people to get in, you know, get that feel for it, and then hopefully stick with the sport.
What's awesome for me is like that, you know, I like what Matten did with, you know, the with his novice states at the Seagate. 800, over 800 kids, right?
Yeah.
But you know, it's not the OEC, right? That's not what you're signing your kid up for. It's beginners, right?
Yeah.
Having options and continuing to grow, how can you contribute to what your dad and your cousin have already established?
You know, I don't know if they need much help. They do a pretty good job, but I want to stay here and make sure that the quality of the tournament runs the way that it's expected to as an OAC event. And then as far as what I do with coaching and stuff, I just want to give back to the kids. For me, it's more about leaving them better than when we found them, trying to get young men. And, you know, if they're successful on the mat, that's great too, but they've got a whole career and life ahead of them after high school or even college, so that's a little bit more important.
Okay, so OAC's growth, part of it has been flow wrestling. Now it's going over to track. But social media, you're a social media guy.
Yeah.
Well, how huge is social media and promotion of events like what I do?
You know, I mean, you do an outstanding job. Actually, when I saw you come today, I was like, oh, great. I don't have to do any video. There's no stress on me because I do try to do it when you're not there. But social media is huge. That's actually part of what I do for my real job. And the OEC's been doing a really great job of it, making sure to get pictures out there, the videos, getting people to learn how to use the website with some of the new technologies that we have. You know what? We just had a talk earlier today about making sure we're getting the good podium pictures later today. And someone said, well, why need you pictures? And I said, well, if there isn't a picture, it didn't happen. And that's kind of, you know, that's the world that we live in.
Right? In that video, I looked at that like 36-minute video where they have all the guys labeled from the state placements for junior high, 2006 to 2018. That's huge. Mm-hmm. That's huge. And a lot of people are like, oh, this is lame. That is how I've actually labeled some of the old matches videos that I have. I had to go back and watch that video,
yeah,
which is totally crazy to think about. Okay, so saturation. I'm like a person who blasts things out shotgun style. I shoot everything.
Uh-huh.
Compare that to someone who has a lot of clout, you know, like a saturator, right? Like someone who just, I blast tons of things. I've already done 10 posts today, right?
Yeah, I know. I get them on my watch.
You get them on your watch. Okay, but what's that like? Some people get that, that's like little mentally straining on some people and they unfollow, right?
I think it's different in this sport. I think, you know, obviously people are at different levels, but I for one, I can't get enough wrestling at whatever level it is.
Saying keep on keeping on, Zeb.
Heck yeah, man. I mean, it's great for the sport too. It's great to get that out there for more people to see it. And I think you see now, at least I've noticed, that colleges are doing that too. I mean, they're doing all, they're tweeting all the match results.
Every takedown, everything.
Dirty,
right?
Flow scrambles, stuff like that. I say the more the better. I think it's great for the sport. I think that's one of the ways that we'll grow the sport, for sure.
All right. right, you got to get in there. You got work to do. You got anything else for me to do?
No, man. Just keep doing what you're doing, and we're happy to have Barbarian Apparel here and Defense Soap too. They're such great partners. So thanks, Zeb.
Hey, thanks for the time. Get in there. Get some grinding done. I know you got some work to do. Don't shoot any videos. Don't steal my work from me. All right?
You bet.